there was a lot of buzz in the media about those who are working in the front lines not having the resources available to fight this pandemic. Seth and I put our heads together to figure out how to start producing shields.
A couple weekends ago, I was reading some of the articles online about how the personal protective equipment was running short in parts of our world where the coronavirus is already very active. Any protective equipment that's available right now that's extra is getting funneled to the parts of our country and our world where people need it most. On the news about healthcare workers who sort of had like this crease across their forehead from wearing their face shield for 12 hours, my thought was, wow, can't we design something that's a little bit more comfortable? I found that Joseph Prusa's design has a nice wide band, so it distributes the load across the forehead. Would be a little bit more comfortable for someone to have to wear for 12 hours, maybe more, but was something that could be easily manufactured and assembled in a typical makerspace. Really, the need for equipment was 3D printers and then also a laser cutter for the face shields themselves. And that's equipment that we have here at the Deason Innovation Gym. So the first thought that came to my mind is, okay, all the students are gone, and they're busy picking their classes. Our space isn't occupied. Alyssa, the manager, and I had already disinfected the entire space, so why don't we convert this to a facility for small batch manufacturing for face shields to help support our healthcare workers here in the Dallas area?
It's an iterative process, and one of our mottos in this space is learn by doing and don't be afraid of failure. And I would say that we definitely live up to that every day. We have 7 printers going consistently every day, printing out the halos. After the usual process of elimination, the usual issues, we are now sort of in a groove, and we've printed about 200 shields at this point, which is pretty amazing.
Right now we're focusing almost entirely on UT Southwestern. They have the ability to distribute to a group of hospitals and clinics more than just themselves.
Hopefully we can make a few hundred, if not more. Sort of depends on how long this lasts and how long people will be needing this extra support, since it's so hard to find personal protective equipment in the marketplace right now. I hope that we at least make a small impact on our local community with the hospitals and clinics and people that we can get the shields to. We're not the only ones around the world doing this kind of stuff. I hope that all of our small parts will add up and make a huge difference overall as we come together and help one another.
My expectation is to continue to produce face shields for as long as we can. We may run out of materials, and if that happens, then we just have to stop. But as long as demand continues, we will continue to provide face shields to healthcare workers until this pandemic has passed us by.